अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, कैसे हैं आप लोग? उम्मीद है सब ठीक होंगे। आज हम करने जा रहे हैं अपने जो फर्स्ट चैप्टर है सेकंड ईयर का इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर 12। उसका टॉपिक नंबर जो लास्ट हमने किया था वो था 12.6 इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स थ्रू अ स्फेयर सरफेस इनक्लोजिंग अ चार्ज। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस स्टडी नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज 12.7 गॉसस लॉ। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, गॉसस लॉ actually deals with the electrostatics phenomena, and Gauss studied about the electric field intensity and he find out the mathematical expression how can you find out the E, which is electric field intensity. So this is the practical applications of electrostatics in which you can find out the electric field through any body. The body may be a spherical shape or any arbitrary shape, किसी भी shape की body हो सकती है। तो electric flux का concept हमने पढ़ा 12.6 के अंदर। electric flux हमारे पास क्या था कि number of electric field of lines जो थी which is passing through a per unit area, उसे हमने नाम दिया था electric flux का। तो इसके पहले जो हमने पढ़ा था कि इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स थ्रू अ क्लोज सरफेस और थ्रू अ सरफेस विच इज इनक्लोजिंग विच हैविंग अ यूनिट पॉजिटिव चार्ज, वो हमने निकाला था 1 और एप्सिलॉन नॉट मल्टीप्लाई बाय क्यू। कि हमारे पास कोई भी आर्बिट्रेरी शेप हो तो उसके लिए जो है इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स क्या होगा वो गॉसस ने रिप्रेजेंट किया। लेट्स सपोज हमारे पास एक आर्बिट्रेरी शेप की बॉडी है और इस के ऊपर जो है इसके ऊपर सरफेस के ऊपर नहीं बल्कि इनसाइड दिस बॉडी वी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड द नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस। से दिस इज पॉइंट चार्ज Q1, दिस इज पॉइंट चार्ज Q2 एंड दिस इज पॉइंट चार्ज Q3, Q4, Q5 एंड मैनी मोर। सपोज दिस बॉडी इनक्लोजिंग अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस and actually we have distributed these charges inside the body. Now let's see what is the resultant, what will be the result of distributing the number of charges if a body enclosing a lot of charges. So what will be the electric flux, what will be the electric field intensity? So Gauss explained that if you have a number of charges, let's suppose Q1, Q2, Q3 and so on, there are infinite number of charges, so how can you find out the electric field, electric flux, electric flux density for these number of charges? Because in the previous section we studied about a single charge electric flux, we studied about what will be the electric field intensity, what will be the electric flux if a body enclosing a unit positive charge. So now let's see how and how can we find out the resultant of these charges, the resultant of their electric field, electric flux through that body. According to this formula, you can see that the electric flux E of that body, because there are number of charges, there is not only a single charge but there are lot of charges, so we can write Q like this, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus so on. Okay, so if we have a number of charges which is infinite, let's suppose this is Qn. We don't know what is Qn, how many Qs. Actually we don't have any idea what are number of charges, okay, how many number of charges, but we simply represented the general term n, but we don't know what is n. So now if you multiply, actually if you can represent this by a single charge, let's suppose this is number of charges and you represent this whole number of charges by Q, so you can say that actually Q is a lot of charges a Q is a sum of all the charges inside that body. Okay, so now actually this is Q, and this Q is the total number of charges. Okay, this is a total number of charges enclosed by a surface. Okay, so total number of charges enclosed by surface, we representing this term by a capital Q. Now it implies that we can write this as epsilon naught into Q. So this is the mathematical formation, which is not, actually you can see that there is no difference. The previous one, so this is no more difference between the previous one, which is electric flux for a unit positive charge. Now Gauss has explained that if we have a lot of number of charges enclosing by a closed body or a closed surface, then how can we find out the electric flux? E represented by the electric flux, this formula, phi E equals 1 over epsilon naught, which is a space, free space permittivity, or you can say the electric constant, and Q is a total number of charges enclosed by that closed body or a closed surface. So what will be the statement now? Actually, according to Gauss's law, the total number of field of lines, or mean to say the flux, actually the field of lines per unit area, we says we represented this term by a flux. The flux, or the total flux through any closed surface, the flux, or you can say that the total flux through any closed surface is 1 over epsilon times the total charge enclosed by that surface. Okay, so this is the statement of this mathematical expression. Actually this is a statement of the Gauss's law. This says that total flux through any closed surface is 1 over epsilon times the total charge enclosed by that surface. So this is Gauss's law. Actually what are the application of the Gauss's law, we are going to discuss in our next topic or our next lecture. Actually Gauss's law uses to find out the E, which is the electric field intensity, and also there is another application. By using the Gauss's law, you can also find out the relation, you can also derive the relation for the Coulomb's law. So this is another application, this is another utilization of the Gauss's law. By using the Gauss's law, you can find out the Coulomb's law, and by using the Gauss's law, our major purpose is that we can find out the E, electric field intensity, or the electric intensity. So our next topics, our next lectures, we will find out the electric field intensity for the different surfaces enclosing by a charge or containing a charge.